Made this video to share with you different reasons why you are not seeing any result with your tretinoin cream, or why it's so difficult for you to use tretinoin cream, or another way is that why you are not getting the result with tretinoin cream. We're gonna talk about it today, and hopefully this video will help you have successful result with tretinoin cream. So the first thing I would say, most of people are, when they start tretinoin cream, they start with a higher percentage. They start with 1%, and most of the people that start sometimes tretinoin is because maybe they have issue, they have like acne issue or something like that, so they're trying to fix the problem. And when they go to see the dermatologist, some dermatologists prescribe them a higher percentage, for instance 1%, okay? And that's the reason why the tretinoin, because it's so strong, is going to give them problem. It's going to be very difficult for them to deal with tretinoin. The thing you have to understand about tretinoin is that your skin need to be accustomed to tretinoin. That's the first goal. Your first goal with tretinoin is not to see result. The first goal is to help your skin get accustomed to it. And after your skin is accustomed to it, is where you're gonna start to see result. I recommend with tretinoin cream, instead of using 1%, maybe start with 0.025%. That's what I recommend. Or you can also start with 0.05% if you want to, but if I needed to start over, I will start with 0.025% to get my skin accustomed to it. And when I'm done with the 0.025%, maybe for 6 months or 1 year, then I'm gonna jump up to 0.05%. You can also use different other type of tretinoin cream. You don't have to use tretinoin cream on your skin. I made a video last time on the 5 different type of tretinoin that I'm using on my my face. Go ahead and watch this video and choose one of those products to start your regimen with vitamin A. You don't have to use tretinoin cream if you don't want to. There are other type of product that can give you the same result. The second thing you're not seeing result and you're having problem or issue with tretinoin is because you are using it too much, like every day. You are using it. Yes, I know your dermatologist told you to use it every day. Yes, I understand, okay? I understand, but you have to understand that we have black skin, and black skin is the most sensitive skin on the earth, in my opinion, okay? So using tretinoin cream every day is going to give you issue. Your skin is going to get darker, your skin barrier is going to be destroyed, your skin is not going to handle it. Normally tretinoin cream is supposed to lighten your skin, okay? It's supposed to fight hyperpigmentation, but you're going to discover that your skin is getting darker and darker, and that's because your skin is inflamed. And when dark skin is inflamed, it means what? Hyperpigmentation. So using it every day, I do not recommend it. What I recommend is to use, at least when you use tretinoin cream or tretinoin gel, I personally recommend to use it 2 times per week or 3 times per week only. So the third thing is that you do not wear sunscreen. Yes, you do not wear sunscreen on your face, and that's why you're having problem. That's why your face is not protected. That's why your face is darkening, okay? Because you do not use sunscreen. And even if you use sunscreen, maybe you are using sunscreen that are causing your face to get irritated or inflamed. One of the type of sunscreen that may cause issue in my experience, are chemical sunscreen. So you will have to really be wise with your sunscreen, Personally, nowadays, I really recommend to use a mineral sunscreen base or a sunscreen that contains mineral and chemical sunscreen at the same time. I would say those are more safe and those are really going to help you deal with tretinoin. I would say that, okay, because tretinoin is very harsh. Tretinoin is a medication, okay? So you need something that is not going to cause you more issue. You need something that is going to come and protect your face, that is going to smooth your face. And that's why I recommend a physical sunscreen or a sunscreen that contain physical and chemical sunscreen at the same time. Another reason why you are not seeing any result and you're having problem with your tretinoin cream journey is because you are using tretinoin cream at the same time you are using acid. Yes, I know people, white skin, white people, okay? When you see those video on YouTube with those dermatologists, okay? They are all white and they are the one using acid before using tretinoin, okay? Those are the ones doing those things on their face. And yes, they can, because their skin can support that. Their skin can handle it. But black skin, no, that's an other issue, okay? Black skin is different, and there are a small percentage of black skin that can really handle acid and tretinoin cream at the same time. So my advice for you is that do not use any type of acid when you use your tretinoin cream. And I will even go to the extent and say, when you use tretinoin cream, do not use any acid. Especially if you are a beginner. If you are a beginner, do not use any type of acid on your face. Only focus on using your tretinoin treatment, your tretinoin cream, only by itself. Don't add any type of acid, because tretinoin cream also exfoliates the skin, okay? It turns the cells of your skin, okay? It gives you that smooth skin, that beautiful skin. That's the job of tretinoin cream. So at the beginning, my dear, or if you're having problem with tretinoin cream, avoid any type of acid on your skin. If you watch a lot of my video, you have noticed that I mention niacinamide a lot in my videos. And yes, the reason for it is because niacinamide is an ingredient that goes very well with tretinoin cream. And niacinamide, personally, I use it in the morning and I use it at night as well, because I know how he can help my skin. In the morning, I like to use niacinamide because it's going to help me protect my skin, okay? And it's also going to help me fight my hyperpigmentation because I have dark skin. But at night, I like to use niacinamide because it's a great additional ingredient for my skin. It's going to help me prevent or smooth the side effect of tretinoin cream. Niacinamide is that ingredient that I feel like you need to use it in combination with tretinoin cream or any type of vitamin A. Those two work great together. They are good together. It's gonna help you, minimize the side effect or minimize the problem of tretinoin cream or vitamin A. That's why I recommend to use niacinamide in the routine. That's what I do, and I recommend that if you want to. But if you have any issue with niacinamide, your skin doesn't like niacinamide, please don't use it on your skin at all. Maybe try to use a serum that contains centella before applying your tretinoin cream or your vitamin A. And the last thing I'm going to say today, because there are a lot of advice I can give you, but I can make another video about it. The last thing is that, please, when you feel it, if you feel that your skin is inflamed, if you feel like your skin is irritated, if you feel like your skin has something, do not apply tretinoin cream on your face that day or for like 1 week. To let your skin reset, to let your skin heal. Because if your skin is inflamed and you apply tretinoin, the tretinoin is going to come and and make that issue worse. So it's best to take a break sometimes. You see, guys, I've been using tretinoin cream since 2018, 2019, and I took breaks. There are weeks where sometimes I don't use the tretinoin cream at all, no vitamin A. There are period of the day that sometimes I say, okay, this week I'm not gonna use any type of tretinoin cream at all. I'm only gonna use like a retinol serum, for instance. And there are weeks where I took a break from tretinoin cream or vitamin A. Any type of vitamin A, retinol, tretinoin cream, tretinoin gel, the serum, I took a break for 1 week or 2 weeks to let my face reset, to let my skin heal and reset. And the only thing I was giving to my skin was moisturizer, hydration. I was using great moisturizers and great serum to only pump my skin with hydration and moisture. That's it. And you need to understand that our skin need those moisture and hydration is the most important thing. And that's why I recommend to do, anytime you feel that your face is in trouble, give up those vitamin A, give up those tretinoin. I'm gonna say something. I love and I like tretinoin cream. Since I started using tretinoin cream or tretinoin gel, my skin has been very, very different. I have acne prone skin, but you cannot imagine. You cannot, when you see me today, I'm a different person. Even today at church, I have no makeup on my face. The only thing that I have on my face is my mineral sunscreen. I put my eyeliner, I put my mascara, and that's it. But at church, black women were telling me that I have a beautiful skin. I was surprised. I didn't even put on my skin like a skin tint or something, but I was getting compliments. And I noticed that I really, really minimize my skincare routine. I minimize it. I'm trying to use good products that I know. Vitamin A is my key product, is my key ingredient. Tretinoin cream or tretinoin gel, this is my key ingredient. I think that I can't live without tretinoin cream, okay? But you also need to be wise on how to use it, on when to use it, on the different things you need to do. You need to be wise about it. You need to know that to have successful result. And again, if tretinoin cream is causing you issue, it destroys your skin, please stop. Stop. And watch my video on tretinoin 101. Or watch my last video on where I talk about the 5 different type of vitamin A you can use on your face. You don't have to use tretinoin cream, but you can use substitute or cousin of tretinoin cream to have the same result as me at the long run. My face is not perfect. I still have pimples because I have acne prone skin, but you don't see acne all over my face like I used to. It's different. So thank you guys, and I see you in my next video. Bye-bye.